Good afternoon to all jury members, my senior fellows, and all my dear friends. I am Dr. Deepak Kumar, junior resident on the Department of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology from Dr. Rajendra Prasad Government Medical College, Kangra at Tanda in Himachal Pradesh. And the topic is the role of omics in forensic medicine. First, the field of forensic medicine is aligned to other branches of science like forensic science, toxicology, psychiatry, genetics, and many more. Forensic science share a common scientific methodology with other science disciplines or technologies. So omics emerges as a priority step in the forensic medicine and forensic science. Now, what is omics? It is the branch of science known informally as omics are various branches in biology whose names end with the suffix omics. So the genes related to genomics, mRNA related to transcriptomics, protein related to proteomics, and the suffix omics metabolite related to metabolomics. The sample which we can be used in the forensic study is blood, urine, hair, nail, feces, vitreous humor. These all sample we can be used in the omics study. Now, what is genomics? Genomics is the study of whole genome of organism and integrates elements from the genetics. Now, various techniques and most common techniques which can be used are RT-PCR, MALDI-TOF-MS, microarray, next generating sequencing, etc. Now, the role of genomics in forensic medicine is, number one is detection of the biological specimen. The detection of DNA to match a suspect to a scene of crime through identification of body fluids. Nakanishi investigate bacteroid family on the different biological specimens like sweats, urine, blood, and other specimens. And he found that the bacteroids, the species and strain which are related to uniformis and vulgaris, they are only found in the feces. So if the result showed that if the sample contain uniformis and vulgaris species, the sample contain feces. Genomic approaches in microbial flora is an extremely promising and potential tool in the future forensic applications. Number two, to detect postmortem interval. Here is the role of microbiomes and epinecrotic bacterial community come into play. As we know, necrobiomes defined as the community of species associated with decaying, decomposed corpse remain. And after the death, the immune system is no longer active. Microbes colonize in the body of any disease and become very complex community. Because of this process, the gases are released causing bloating. Eventually, gas seep through the body wounds and natural opening and come in the outer aspect from the natural orifice. And by this process, some microbial community from the inside come into the outside community, in the community of the environment, and determine the time and location of death for an individual. Different microbes play scientific role during each stage of decomposition. Number three is intoxication and abuse of drug. Pharmacogenomics and toxicogenomics methods may protect someone from being guilty of a crime. For an example, Sally in 2010 published a report of 9-year boy old who has multiple psychiatric disorder and was on medication phenylephrine, clonidine and fluoxetine. After 10 months of medication, he developed GI symptom and died due to cardiac arrest followed by a status epilepticus. Postmortem toxicological report of disease show that there are several fold higher fluoxetine and non-fluoxetine concentration. So disease parents investigated because of possible fluoxetine intoxication. But in the later, pharmacogenomic and toxicogenomic studies of the disease show that boy had a very poor cytochrome P450 metabolizer genotype, resulting in accumulation of fluoxetine. Thus, child's parents were cleared from all the charges. Next is diagnosis of disease and cause of death. Cardiac molecular autopsy has ability to provide a physiopathological basis for sudden unexpected death and aims to detect the genomic risk of an individual. In 2004, testers performed a molecular autopsy with cardiac autopsy of 49 cases of sudden unexpected death cases. In their study, a pathogenic cardiac channel mutation detected in 35% of SUD cases and RYR2 mutation was present in one of every 7 cases of SUD. So consequently, it is of high importance to feedback disease relatives for the similar genomic risk and direct them to a clinician for onset of appropriate prevention. Next is proteomics. Proteomics is the study of proteomes. Proteomics determine amino acid sequence, modification, structure, and possible pathway in the cell that can help in the development of new biomarker in forensic medicine. The commonly used techniques are ELISA, CELD, LC-MS, MSIA, and MALDI. The role to detect the biological fluid, as discussed in genomics, the proteomics-based strategies have been developed to detect and identify the protein, certain specific marker of biological fluid on a surface during scene investigation without any destruction of the DNA. So we can double confirm the any biological fluid from the genomic study and the proteomic study. MS-based proteomic approaches can be introduced to detect the origin of specimens and identification of the body samples. To know the postmortem interval by the degradation of the skeletal muscle protein. Pittner in 2014 studied on the Potkin muscle, and in 2016 study he studied the skeletal muscle of human beings, and study shows result that some of the muscle proteins like desmond, titin, cardiac troponin T, and SERCA1 decrease regularly and predictively by the time. Second option is by usability of bone proteomics such as bioglycan, which play a role in the bone growth and mineralization, start decreasing after death. Now the diagnosis of disease and cause of death. How can proteomics help? Proteomics carry a promising potential to assess risk factor and find out pathophysiological mechanism in sudden unexplained death in early period of life by knowing abnormal protein concentration and a signal protein. Broadwell studied in 2012 on the SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome cases, and he found a significant decrease in the tryptophan hydroxylase and serotonin level in the gigantocellular position of the medullary system. Proteomic studies may be supportive in determining anaphylaxis-related cause of death by measuring tryptase and beta-tryptase level. Next is metabolomics. Metabolomics is the large-scale study of small molecules, commonly known as metabolites. Collectively, these small molecules, metabolic intermediates, hormones, and other signaling molecules, and their interaction within a biological system are known as metabolome. Commonly used techniques are gas chromatography mass spectroscopy, LC-MS, FTIR, Raman spectroscopy, DIMS, and NMR, etc. Now the role to detect the postmortem interval. As we know, after death, the microbes complex community change the metabolic and biochemical profile of the tissue, which varies in the accordance with the manner of death by significantly increasing and decreasing metabolites. That is shown to correlate with PMI. Number two is intoxication and abuse of drug. Here comes the genome metabolite, that is detection of urinary drug metabolites. The detection of drugs in urine and appropriate utilization of statistical method to determine the relation to the metabolites has been shown to be useful to find out the time of intake of drug and postmortem interval. Besides urine and blood, hairs and nail can also be used in the metabolomic experiments in order to detect metabolites, abuse drug, or explore toxic agents. Now next, the diagnosis of disease and cause of death. The metabolomics have ability to reveal a clear picture of metabolic profile and status of organisms. It can also be utilized for diagnosis of certain diseases such as Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson, preeclampsia, IUGR, anaphylaxis reaction, and establishing the cause of death. Now the transcriptomics. Transcriptome is the whole set of RNA transcripts produced by entire genome. Transcriptomics defines novel technologies focusing on studying the transcriptome of an organism, which utilize microarray analysis and PCR as common analytical methods. Now the role, the postmortem to detect postmortem interval. The transcriptomic approach carries a potential to explain cell viability during the process toward local necrosis or death. An analysis of mRNA has ability to provide its quantitative evidence. Diagnosis of disease and cause of death. The application of postmortem transcriptomics by using RNA sequencing in specimens obtained in early postmortem period shows promising results for various psychiatric illness in initial studies. Now the conclusion, all four omics and their subdivision interact with each other. The close relationship among the omics provide more reliable and useful information when used in combination from at least two omics. The omics in forensic medicine and science are of high importance to promote the reinforced evidence-based evaluation of medical legal questions in trauma cases, crime scene-related issues, the cause, mechanism, and the manner of death. So it is high time to incorporate omics approach into routine medical legal application, death assessment, as well as autopsy cases. However, more investigation is needed for the future perspectives. Thank you.